Hi.
Can you hear me?
That's an impressive response.
Okay. Hi, everyone. My name is Ziv Lautman. I'm originally from Israel. I'm one of the co-founders and chief marketing officer of a company called Breezometer. We are the weather channel or AccuWeather or your weather service for air quality. We are a completely software-based company. We're not developing any sensors. Many people ask us how do we know air quality, so we're not measuring from any of our own sensors. We're a big data analytics company. We're mapping the world's air pollution by gathering many different data sets that affects the air we breathe. It can be traffic, it can be emissions, it can be weather, satellite data, and ground monitoring stations that belong to the government. And what I would like to show you today is how we see air quality and air pollution all around the world. What is unique about our technology is that we've been able to map air pollution in real time in the resolution of a city block and even up to the resolution of streets in more than 7,000 cities all around the world. So I will start with China, but not Beijing. This is a small city in terms of China called Lishui. And I even also placed two sensors, two data sets that we gather. There are two governmental monitoring stations that measure air quality in the corners. This is the basic layer of our data, but we're using many more data layers of traffic, emissions, and many more. And you will see now how air pollution moves and changes at the course of an hour. So the time is on the right, and you can see suddenly there's an air pollution event starting on the left. You can see the red color, the script, the monitor is not the best, but suddenly it disappears, and there's like a better air quality entering the area. So this is an issue. You can see how air quality changed pretty fast. This event was from Israel last year. So there was a dust storm coming from the desert, from Egypt, from the Sahara, and you can see how it covered all Israel in the course of 12 hours, starting from the south to the north. So you can see the difference between the two movies. The first was in a very high local resolution, as we more love to do, and this is in a higher level. This one is from Japan, in a place called Osaka. And you can see here how air quality changed really the course of hours due to many different factors, due to traffic, due to emissions, local events, weather events. So the red again, red means higher pollution, green means it's better. I hope you can see the colors better now. There's, for example, there's an air pollution that's starting here, over there, then it changed. So you can see even during the night, where you won't think there will be a higher pollution events. The next movie is a very interesting one from Valencia, Spain. So there's an airport here, and you'll see how the airport really affects the whole city in terms of pollution, how it changed along the day with more departures, more arrivals, etc. So the next question probably you'll ask, okay, so you have air quality data, now what do you do with it? So we've been able to monetize it. They were selling the air quality data to many different companies around the world. We have one of our customers and partners, companies like AccuWeather, Dyson, and Motorola. We have Veolia, if you're familiar with, working with Mount Sinai Hospital in New York. If you have Apple HealthKit, we're providing all the air quality data to one of the official Apple Health apps called Asthma App, and many more. And so on one hand, we're selling air quality data, we're a data provider, we have an API, you can go to our website, breezometer.com, and start using the data for your own products. On the second hand, we are working in cities all around the world, in smart cities. We launched the data a year ago, and then cities started to ask us, how do we do what we do? We showed them the backend platform, and basically said, the backend platform. We developed a software service solution, and today we're working with cities on helping them to find where the pollution is coming from, who are the polluters, where the pollution is going to go, how to affect people's health. Is current policy actually working? And maybe I'll just finalize with some numbers. Air pollution today is the number one cause of premature death. More people dying from air pollution than car accidents, HIV, malaria combined. More than 5 million people, and of course all of you know someone who has lung or heart disease. It's a real epidemic of the 21st century. It's not only in Asia, only in the US. I don't know if you saw Tesla event. They almost told that more than 50,000 people dying only from transportation, not to mention power plants, emissions, etc. So it's a real problem. And we are here to solve it as the first step, to visualize it and to show where the pollution is, where it comes from, and then you can actually do something about it. I'm here. I'm happy to answer any questions. Thank you.
Yeah, can you talk a little bit about the back end you built? Like what's driving the analytics?
Yeah, so we've been using Google Cloud. We're using Google Cloud, BigQuery, App Engine. So the algorithm that we're using, so from the 70s, air quality dispersion and how pollution moves is well known research and algorithms were developed, but they weren't adapted to real-time calculation. When I was a student, we used to press the run button in the computer and wait a week or two. That's exactly what's going on today in municipalities. They don't have the ability to run real-time, very hyper-local calculations. So we took these algorithms, we adapted them to real-time, to new data feeds that exist, like traffic, like satellites, and run those models on, and unfortunately, I'm not a software engineer, so I know we're running them on BigQuery, on Google Cloud, and we're doing today billions of calculations in an hour. And so that's the main, we'll say, gap that we have to be able to go. And we published an article today to Google. If you Google the results before the news, you find the use case for Google Cloud, how we use Google Cloud to be able to do that.
How or where did you generate your revenue from?
So we're a data company. We have two main revenue streams. One is we're selling the data, and just as companies buy weather data, so companies also buy air quality data, different companies, smart home, fitness, health, we have insurance, real estate. It's a very diverse company in the field that wants to have quality data. And second, we're working with cities. Not directly with cities, we usually have an integrator in between. For example, we just launched a partnership a couple of days ago with the biggest smart meter company, Park Meter. We're working in cities, and we're selling software as a service solution through an integration between. Any more questions?
Yeah. Can you talk a little bit more about where exactly you're getting your data and how you're ensuring that it's real time in some ways?
So all the data is open data. We're using the data is open and free, but it took us 2 years to collect all the data from governments, to sign agreements with governments that we can use data. So there are real-time data feeds from, for example, governmental monitoring station, traffic, emissions, not in all places, but in some places. And satellites, there is near real-time data. We're, of course, using predictions, we're using trends historically, but most of the data is real-time. And I'm saying real-time is usually in gaps of 20 minutes, or It takes today 20 minutes to do the calculations. 20 minutes, 30 minutes, depends where and how dense is the data. So we call it real time because it's near real time. So we check air quality in our app, that was the air quality for plus minus 20 minutes.
So you mentioned there are some equipment you can already measure the air quality real time. time, so why do I want to use your product to use some model and data to predict what the air quality is? Because there's some equipment already telling me the air quality right now. So why do I need your model to predict the some measurement?
So yeah, there are many apps if you look that are showing air quality, and it's a good point. So currently all the solutions out there were not developed by professionals from the field, or they're just apps that tapping into these governmental data sets and just showing a very raw data. Most of them, I can tell you, are wrong. And we discovered that actually we had a very interesting use case. When we started to show the real data, people didn't believe us and believe the other apps, but they're actually showing the wrong data. Many of them are doing calculations that are just wrong, and they're not analyzing the data. They're just showing a very wrong data. Our uniqueness, and what you've seen in the movie, is that we're analyzing the dispersion of pollution. Usually the data that you get can be from a sensor 2 miles away from you. And maybe it's not even relevant, because if the wind is going in the other direction, it's really not relevant. So that is why we're analyzing the pollution, because it must be analyzed just like weather, it can change a lot.